It was a great excuse to get together and practice some things. We played a little bit together, but this was just in a whole new level of figuring out how things go.
We tune because we care.
Praise God. Well, we're going to start out with one of mine called Revelation 3:20. This is a new song for me. And it's a sing-along, so I'm going to sing a phrase and then ask you to join me in it.
Thank you.
Searchlight, and we really liked it, so I'm gonna have fun with that.
We're trying to figure out a good transition between instruments. We haven't figured it out yet.
So how are you feeling today?
Good.
I heard you worked hard already, and you and drove down here like a madman and put up all this sound.
This is really fun, you folks. God bless you for coming.
Well, let's thank Greg for the sound tonight, because he's not being a diva at all. He's done all this hard work. Well, we don't know. Maybe he'll be a diva at some point. But
is there a male and female?
I don't know. I think it's just diva.
Okay.
No matter what.
Searchlight, turn your beam on me.
it's so much fun.
It's a great song.
Thank you, Lord. I was riding in the van. I had, when I first went on the road, I had a band, the three-man band. You might remember that traveling band. Well, there actually was one for a while. We all piled into a van with a sound system. We drove all the way out to California. And when we were in Nevada, there was a town called Searchlight. And you know, it was just desert. We were riding through all this just barrenness. And then all of a sudden there was a green interstate sign that said Searchlight. And it kind of just went into my eyes, you know. So when we got to sing at a Calvary Chapel that was meeting in a casino in Vegas. And thank God there was a church there. And so the whole time that I was there, I was working on that song, Searchlight. And it's just one of my all-time favorites. But I don't feel like doing it all alone. And wow, thank you, Greg. Let's give him a hand for that.
Sweet word of God set my heart on fire. One sweet word of God.
is so precious to me because it's taken from Isaiah 6, and so many wonderful songs have been written from that passage where Isaiah said, I see the Lord, or I saw the Lord high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. And this is just a Honeytree version of that. But I think that the part that there's just a little twist in the way we think of it is it says, I see the Lord high and lifted up, seated on the throne of my life. And that's just a couple of words that the Lord gave me, which make all the difference. When we're not on the throne of our lives, but when Jesus is, that makes all the difference in the world, doesn't it? So I'm really grateful that he allowed me to write this song, and we've been singing for eons. So you guys sing along as soon as you get the hang of it. Some of you probably know it already.
Seated on the throne of my heart.
particular Honeytree song or Greg Hough song that you were thinking of hoping you'd hear tonight?
I know two people who do.
Oh, that'd be fun. It's called Treasures, but the first line, we can play Name That Tune, that's okay, if you can't remember the title. It's a wedding song. But you can, I bet you can pick it up, it's not complicated. Okay. All right, anybody else have one? Yes. Yes. That's what I was fishing for. Good. I know we go back a long time. A lot of us go back together a long time. So don't be afraid to, you know, dig back there in your Honeytree archives. It'll be all right. We'll try our best. So first of all, we'll do Try Maranatha Marathon. Sincere. When he runs, he never wearies. When he walks, he never faints. He is striving for the pasture and cheered on by the saints. Earthly runners may be healthy, but a better race is on. Won't you come and join the runners in the Maranatha Marathon? Well, you can't tell. Church all the time. Pastor Phil will just start launching to something that I don't know even know, you know, I have to figure out what key he's in first of all. And then what is that chord progression? But it's fun, you grow that way. Okay, what was the other one? I forget now. Oh, Treasures. Okay, yeah, that's in C. Everything is in C. for a while here now. Or no, no, it's not. It's in G. It's in G.
I can do that. Jazzy than I remember being, but it'll work. They know that Jesus will stay close to them every day. What does it mean to you? You say to each other, I know two people who do. I lead worship a lot of times on Sunday mornings in different churches, so I'm always listening to new Christian music. There's this song, I just fell in love with it. It's called Holy Water. Has anybody ever heard that?
Mm.
The chorus is so good. The chorus goes, I don't want to abuse your grace. God, I need you every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change.
Amen.
I don't want to abuse your grace. God, I need you every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change. Your forgiveness. Amen. I think I should plug in. I have a choir to sing with me right here at my feet. So you'll hear them sing.
Like sweet, sweet honey on my lips.
sound of the symphony in my ears. It's like pouring water on my skin. I'm a dead man walking, slave to sin. I wanna know about being born again. I need you. Oh Lord, I need you. Every hour and every day. Take me to the riverside. Gonna take me on the baptize. I need you. Yes, God, I need you. Oh, your forgiveness is like sweet, sweet honey on my lips. It's like the sound of a symphony in my ears. It's like pouring water on my skin. Yes, it is. Oh, what? God, I need you every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change. I don't want to lose your grace. God, I need you every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change. Whoa, I don't want to lose your grace. God, I need it every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to sing. Hallelujah! I don't want to abuse your grace. God, I need it every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change. Your forgiveness is like sweet, sweet honey on my lips. Like the sound of a symphony in my ears. It's like the holy water. Your forgiveness is like sweet, sweet honey on my lips. Like the sound of
say don't drink, but I did anyway. So I noticed that I got really sick for the next 3 days, and all of a sudden I started to turn yellow. Well, come to find out, I had been exposed to a young man in the room, and I had held his hand when we prayed, and he had hepatitis that you can get by contact. So I ended up being sick for 4 months. I lost the band I was in. I laid there and shook my fist at God, and all the time God had taken me away from something that would pull me away from Him, but I didn't realize that. So when I laid, at the night I got saved, God said to me, "You will play for me." And I said, "Okay." I was open to that. I extremely open. So I laid in bed and I thought, well, who can that be? Who can I get to be in a band like that? And I remembered a guy named Bob Hartman, a friend of mine, Phil Gonzalez, had introduced me to. And so I got a hold of him and I asked him if he'd want to be in a band. He said, well, no, he had just graduated from college and he was going to go work in a hospital. He had a degree. So I really prayed about it. I said, Bob, are you sure? And I contacted him three different times. And he finally said, okay. No, he didn't. He said, I'm still thinking about it. Well, I had been to a rock concert over in Ohio. And on the way back, all of a sudden someone says, we're coming through Bryan, Ohio. I just said, let me out. He said, what do you mean, let you out? I said, just let me out of the car. Well, how are you going to get home? I said, don't worry, I have something to do. Because Bob lived in Bryan, Ohio. I just got out on the street, and I went to his house, and I didn't even knock. I just opened his door, and I walked in. He was standing in the living room. I said, Bob, we're going to start a band. He had to take me back to the Fort Wayne. But then he said, well, okay. I'm going to go to Christian Training Center in Fort Wayne this fall. I said, okay, I'll go too. And then he said, but I can't play rock and roll anymore. I don't know if it's God. I don't know the thing. And I knew it was, and I knew God was going to use us. And so he said, but I'll play acoustic guitar with you. So we spent the summer, and we wrote a whole bunch of acoustic guitar songs. And we were playing them. And we went to school in the fall, and I met John DeGroff and Bill Glover, the original guys from Petra. And I asked Bill if he'd jam with me sometime, and Bob asked John. And finally, in November, we set up at Calvary Temple on the sanctuary, and we jammed. We came off the stage, and Bob said, okay, I'll do this. But that's how Petra got started.
Isn't that an amazing story? I love that. Wow. I mean, how easily we could have never had you guys.
Oh, one more thing, I don't need to take the time to. Honeytree had an album, she went down to Tennessee and had it made, came back, and somehow a record company found her and bought the album from her, and she went off and was playing all over the place, and her album was in all the music stores, almost the Christian music store in the United States. And we were just a fledgling band. We played like churches or anything free out in the park. And the guy, Billy Ray Hearn was his name, he called her manager and asked, he said, are there any other Christian bands around? We're looking for new acts. And he said, well, there's these guys in our church that are called Petra. He said, well, can you get me a demo of those guys? So Paul Craig and us guys, we went over to a studio in Pekin, Illinois. Paul Craig played piano with us on this.
Oh my God!
Yes, he did.
I didn't know that part of the story.
And we made four songs, and they were terrible. I was so embarrassed. I thought, well, there goes our music career. But he liked us and signed us up. So Honeytree was really responsible for me getting to be where I was. God used her.
Praise the Lord.
Did you know that?
No, I did not. But I also want you to know who was responsible for me getting on Moon Records was Andre Crouch. Remember, he used to come to our church and play Andre Crouch and the Disciples, and he was so friendly, and he liked my songs and was always encouraging me. And after I made my little record, it was like what they used to call it a custom album, where you just make them, you print 1,000 copies, and that's it. You know, you don't have a record contract or anything. You sell them at your little gates, and that's a custom album. Well, he took an armload of them and went to the CBA convention, and he was a big star at the CBA convention. And so there was this radio guy who said, will you please do an interview for me on my radio while we're here at the convention? And Andre said, I will do it on the condition that you interview me, but you play this Honeytree album. And that was a guy named Paul Baker who had a big show in Texas. And so that's how that happened. He made the guy play my music in order to get him to be interviewed. Isn't that awesome?
That is awesome.
Let's clap our hands and thank the Lord. He's the one that can open that kind of door that no man can shut. And so we're going to sing the song Pioneer, just in honor of how God used ordinary people that were saved and on fire for Jesus, and just musicians to do something that was called Jesus music. Mandolin, one more mandolin. We're going to do up to 7. something good. Boy, that was just shameless fishing. Okay.
I didn't want to disappoint you.
Come on, let's learn this one together. Together for the good of those who love him and are called according to his purpose. And sometimes we find ourselves in a place where we've got something going on that we really can't imagine how God is going to make something good out of it. And that's what this song is good for. So I want you to sing this again. I want you to just take your hand and lift it up to the Lord. And in that hand, represent what it is that you can't imagine how God's going to make something good out of it. But you're proclaiming your faith in his word. Amen? Let's sing it together. I'm going to believe that you are up to something good. I'm going to believe that you are up to something good. And when I can't understand the things that happen in my life, I'm going to believe.
I remember years ago ago, I took in a young man to stay at my house, and he had been in trouble and done different things, and we started taking him to church, and he was doing really well. And then he got busted for drugs. They threw him in the jail for a while. Then he got out of jail, and he came back, and he stayed with us again, and seemed to be doing really well. And one day, he just came home, and he said, "I can't take it anymore." He said, "I gotta get out of here." I said, "Jason, what are you gonna do?" He said, "I'm gonna go to Texas." He said, "I'm gonna leave." Well, he did, and he got busted and thrown in jail. But in the process of that, this song is actually about him. He goes, "It's a long, hard road to freedom when you say you can't be free. So you live your life as someone who never finds who they can be. So you're going to start a new life. You're going to walk away from everyone and everything that taught you how to pray. You say you're a follower, but you won't give up your lead. So you render yourself powerless to a life filled with defeat. You try to lay your head down and close your eyes to sleep, but you're haunted by the promises that you didn't think to keep. Restless heart, don't walk away. It's still not too late. Restless heart, come home, I pray. Come back home to stay." Well, he eventually turned out, and has been good for years now, that he's one of those kids that's had a rough beginning, but this song is about him. It's called Restless Heart. The original name was Jason's song. But it's a good song to play when you're going to tell people they need to know Jesus.
Come back home. restless heart, don't walk away. It's still not too late. Restless heart, come home, I pray. Come back home to stay. Restless
to mandolin again.
The next time we do a show, we have to have our writer there. Somebody comes and passes me my instruments.
What writer?
Well, several years back, I woke up in the middle of the night and I was singing this song, a song. Where did I hear that song before? And I thought about it. I realized I'd never heard it before. But I was singing it. So I quickly got up and wrote it down. And then it took me, but I just had one little piece. And then it took me 3 months to finish it. But God gave me this.
Oops, your pen. That's okay. Oh, that's okay.
There's nothing else that I'd rather do than raise my hands and give thanks to you. Stand in your glory. Stand in your glory. When my day is done, and my work is through, I bow my head and give thanks to you. Stand in your glory. Stand in your glory. Stand in your glory. Stand in your glory.
Glory, stand in your glory.
having such a great idea. For getting us together. We rehearsed a bunch of times and gosh, this has been really fun.
It's fun when you play with a musician that's so intuitive. Just whatever you do, she goes with it. That's a lot of fun.
I didn't get to be in Petra, but I got to play with Greg Hope. That's pretty cool. I am not ashamed of it.
This is one of the first songs I wrote in Petra. It's called I'm Not Ashamed. I don't know if anyone even remembers it.
Yes.
Wow. Good. Back in the day, do you guys remember when people were getting saved left and right, everywhere you turn?
Yeah. Just kind of walking up to you like, how can I be saved? It was awesome.
I mean, every time we'd have church, people would come down and get saved. It was a magic, powerful time in Jesus.
Amen.
All those people. God did that. I think he'll do that again someday. I'm not trying to prophesy. I don't know anything about that. But I think it's going to happen again. I'd like to be part of that one, too.
Amen.
Amen. So,
yeah. Okay. Me too.
So I'm not ashamed.
Ashamed to say I love you.
chords. Well, I'm telling you, then that was a workout. Oh my God. Thank you. you know Jesus loves you and has a wonderful plan for your life? And he said, oh, I'm sorry I bothered you. Move along. Something wrong. And I said, but Mama, you can rattle me, shake me, smile my breath, and make me roll up both of my sleeves. Search me anywhere you please, but I'm clean. I got nothing to hide. I said, the reason I'm happy is because I got this spirit inside. You don't need to worry about me, because I found out if you know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you don't need anything else. Hallelujah! And she said, oh no, we got a fanatic in the family. Well, the very next day, I was off to school. Now by this time, I knew I had to play it cool. Well, I got to my class, and I sat in my place, but I forgot all about that smile on my face. The teacher saw me grinning and she asked me what for. When I told her I was happy, she marched me out the door and straight to the principal's office, and he said, I'm sorry, but anybody as happy as you are has obviously been smoking in the boys' room. And I said, but sir, I'm a girl, and you can rattle me, shake me, smell my breath, and make me roll up my sleeve. Search me anywhere you please, but I'm clean. Come on, clap your hands now. I got a clap. That you gave us that revelation that it's not a religion, but it's a relationship.
Yes.
And you've been walking with us, Lord. We've been through some hard times, but you've never failed us or forsaken us. You brought us to this place safe and sound today. And so, Lord, we're just going to continue to rock on with you, Lord.
Yes.
Walking on with Jesus. You're the rock, yes, Lord. Thank you that our lives are built on the rock. The storms have come. The wind has blown hard. But Lord, our house didn't fall because we're planted on the rock, Jesus. And we give you the praise. Let's praise the Lord again tonight. Thank you so much for being here.